once my clothes were shabby. Tailors called me cabbie. So I took a vow, said this bummel, beep, bo, brummel. Now I'm smooth and snappy. Now my tailor's happy. I'm the cat's meow. My wardrobe is a wow. Pebrit silk, Hebris tweed. There's only one thing I need. Got my tweed pressed, got my best vest. All I need now is the girl. Got my striped tie, got my hopes high. Got the time and the place and I got rhythm. Now all I need's the girl to go with them. If she'll just appear, we'll take this big town for a whirl. And if she'll say, my darling, I'm yours, I'll throw away my striped tie and my best pressed tweed. All I really need is the girl. Paris silk, Paris tweed. There's only one thing I need. Got my tweed pressed, got my best vest. All I need now is the girl. Got my striped tie, got my hopes high. Got the time and the place and I got rhythm. Now all I need's the girl to go with them. If she'll just appear, we'll take this big town for a whirl. And if she'll say, my darling, I'm yours, I'll throw away my striped tie and my best pressed tweed. All I really need is the girl.
Michael, amazing. Wow, you have such a talent. Your voice is just soaring. Isn't it fun to sing in a mic in a venue like this? It just echoes and it's so beautiful. Well done. Beautiful, beautiful job. Let's see, I wrote down just a couple things as we were going. So I talked to the kids a little bit earlier today about telling a story with your song. And sometimes it means putting yourself in the character as if you're singing that song as the character in the show. I think less and less, unless you're like in final callbacks for that role, that's like not as fun. I think for a cabaret performance with something that like Michael does, or even like I do in concerts and things, bringing yourself to the song is, I think, so much more entertaining in a setting like this. So instead of feeling like you have to like put on the role, showing more of yourself, being able to connect with the audience in a concert setting like this, I think is just will make it more fun. The more fun you're having, the more fun they're, and we are all going to have watching you. So setting the tone at the beginning, using that intro, the minute the music starts, you guys, we are in character. And here I am saying, don't pretend to be the character. But the minute the music starts, you're setting the scene for us. So it's almost like you have to find a situation in your life that you can relate to. So part of me is like, are you going to prom? Do you know what I mean? It's like you're going to prom, you've got your suit all on, and you're just waiting for the perfect date. As opposed to pretending you're Tulsa in Gypsy, I'm like, let's find you in this role and a scenario and situation that you can relate to and just have more fun with it. I think I felt the need. You were like, all I need now is the girl. Like, you're trying to get something, right? This is the purpose as to why you're singing the song. But I think by the end, I want you to find joy in it, mm-hmm. as opposed to just needing it. From the side, as much as we can see here, I saw a little bit of this furrowed brow, and I think there's an element of that. There's a lot of that. Maybe it starts that way, or maybe there's joy at the beginning, and then the second half is more the need, the desire. But I missed a little joy. I wanted you to have even more, like, you look good. I got this, I'm all set, and now I just am waiting for that one thing to complete me. So just having a little bit more fun with it, I think will make it more enjoyable for us. And I think the more you're talking about all these things that you're wearing, looking great, do you find them on you? You know what I mean? You're singing about this, got my best, blah, da, 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 about things on your body. You're like, if I was talking about that, it'd be like, well, I steamed my dress, and I sewed the strap, and I have my sweater on now. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like taking, like, thank you. But like, whatever that is, where it's like, what does it feel like to wear the perfect vest? And the, you know, let us physically see that you're enjoying, that you have all of, that you're buttoned up, and that you like it. I don't think it's okay to acknowledge some of that. Paint the scene for us. And then the lyric, "Darling, I'm yours." It's written to be, "Darling, I'm yours. I'll throw away my da da." But the phrase is actually, if she says, "Darling, I'm yours," comma, "I'll throw away my da-da." Mm-hmm. So making that clear, because she's not saying, "Darling, I'm yours, I'll throw away." She's saying, "Darling, I'm yours," and then you're saying again, "I'll throw away my..." So making sure we just have a little pause in there to be like, on "Darling, I'm yours," you're playing her for a minute, and then it's back to you.
Back to me.
Exactly. So tying those, you were taking a breath, I think, on "I'll throw away my ba," but like, "Darling, I'm yours, I'll throw away my da." Anyway, okay. Let's see. Oh, and then I also think just having an opinion on, like I said, the need was there, but I find a couple times where you're doing it, it's the same thing twice, essentially. We're repeating a lot of lyrics, and you're getting to tell the story twice. So how is it different from first to second? And maybe that is part of it. It starts smaller, and you're envisioning it, and then by the end, it's that celebratory, or by the end, it's that need. Yeah,
celebratory, joyful, like you said. Yeah.
Exactly, finding that joy and making it different, but finding words in there to emphasize instead of "all I need now is the girl." Is it "all I need now is the girl," and then the next time it's "all I need now is the girl." You know what I mean? Finding words that you can pick. One time it's "need," one time it's "one," one time it's "girl." Finding which peppering in just different emphasizes on words in there that just color it in a different way. Mm-hmm. And then, yeah, the joy. Those are my things. Michael, Mr. Feinstein?
How do you follow that?
and easy to be like, okay, go, now do that. Impossible to kind of take all of those things and soak them in, but those are my thoughts.
Well, I love this. I love the song that you chose.
Thank you.
I sing it sometimes, but I don't have your voice, so you have a, if I had your voice, think what I could do. You know? I know you're a dancer, right? Because
yes.
I read your biographical piece. And so you can move a little more with this.
Yeah.
I mean, you could, I know that I terrified everybody about moving too much and doing, because the reason I do that is because most of these incredibly talented singers are not often comfortable with their limbs, what to do with them, because mm-hmm. they'll do this, do mechanical things. But because you're a dancer, you can... I think you can. I can safely predict that you will move without artifice, no pressure. But so feel free to physicalize, as Laura said. Got my tweed pressed. Got my best vest. All I need now is the girl. Got my striped tie. Got my hopes high. Got the time and the place, and I got rhythm. Now all I need's the girl to go with 'em. If she'll just appear, we'll take this big town for a whirl. Mm-hmm. And if she'll say, "My darling, I'm yours," I'll throw away my striped tie and my best pressed tweed. All I really need is the girl. You know, if you could, you know, physicalize it a little bit. Oh, thank you. Copies are on sale in the lobby of my... just to give you an example, that was just to give you, you know, things that you can do, and it can be just little things. Mm-hmm. And also, your expression, you did look a little terrified. I know that wasn't your intention, but you looked like you really didn't want to meet that girl.
Yeah.
Because you're going, all I need is the girl, I need the girl, I need the girl. But it, like, I had a feeling when she came, you go like... You know, because you have the, and I know it's the desire. Again, that is expressed in what you're singing. Mm-hmm. So you can have more fun with it. Mm-hmm. You know, once my clothes were shabby, once they called me cabby, da 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 bo bo brummel. So it's kind of like this and this and then Paris tweet. So if you would start it again, we're actually going to let you sing it again. How about that? So yes, I know you're wedding, like, let them sing. Yeah, I gotcha. Yeah. So do it again, and if you keep doing that furrowed thing when you sing, one day you're going to have to use frownies. Mm-hmm. Frownies are these little things that women used to use, that they sold by the thousands to keep the, you know, men and women frownies. So you don't want to have frownies when you're later and wear frownies, you know. Mm-hmm. So if you do that a lot, it's going to become a thing. So we're going to keep you from getting frownies.
Okay. Find the joy. So. And I think you can take as much time as you want. There's only one thing I still need. Again, emphasizing one of those things, the one or the need. And then we're on the edge of our seats. What is that thing? You know, and the first time you say it, all I need now is the girl. That's what we're waiting for.
Or if you're dyslexic, the grill.
Oh, my gosh.
The grill.
All that's
I
a whole
need
other
now
take.
Is the okay.
That's in Forbidden Broadway.
Happy.
Once my clothes
see,
were
you're
shabby.
Already, see, already went. You already started to do. Once my, uh-huh. You already are. Yeah. So, see, no, you can, you want to have intensity. I understand that. I understand that's why you're doing it. But you can do intensity by this. Once my, by your body language and by this. Once my, and you can put it in your voice. Once my clothes were shabby by doing it. So do it again and just smile. Trust me that smiling will still help you to convey that other thing. Yeah. I promise you. No, it will. It will. Okay?
Once my clothes were shabby,
smile.
Tailors called me cabbie. So I took a vow, said this bummel, beepo brummel. Now I'm smooth and snappy.
Happy.
Now my tailor's happy. I'm the cat's meow. My wardrobe is a wow. Paris silk.
Where is it?
Paris tweed. There's only
What is it?
My tweed.
Okay, now.
Take all the time in the world.
It's got my, both times, the only thing you didn't sing perfectly, so I got to stop. Got my tweed. I can't sing it, but you can, because you're a great singer. So, got my tweed. Got my, see. Anyway, you do it. Terrace, whatever that is.
Paris silk, Paris tweed. There's only one thing I need. Got my tweed pressed, got my best vest. All I need now is the girl. Got my striped tie, got my hopes high, got the time and the place, and I got rhythm. Now all I need's the girl to go with them. If she'll just appear, we'll take this big town for a whirl. And if she'll say, my darling, I'm yours, I'll throw away my striped tie and my best pressed tweed.
Yeah.
All I really need is the girl.
So we're running out of time. That was good, by the way.
Yeah, that was great.
Dude, how's it feel?
10 times better.
Yeah. So continue to work on relaxing here. Because your body's relaxed. It's here that you're so intense. So just keep working on that. And I suggest you look in the mirror, sing it, looking in the mirror, and you'll see exactly what we're talking about. So let's just do the ending, because I've learned many times that when all else fails, if you have a big ending,
the audience sells the whole thing.
Will forgive everything.
Yeah, it's true.
So let's just work on some. Go. You mean the second time?
I have one more thought, Michael. This mm-hmm. last time too, it still looks like you're looking kind of straight out at this like thing, and that's very much for like an audition. That's what you would do. I'm almost like, all I need now is the girl. Like, I think you can start, if you're not afraid of them, you're having a conversation with these people. You're telling them the one thing. Because this, you're connected to a scene partner out there. But to loop the whole audience into this story you're telling, I think you can start to play with them a little.
You have permission to play with them. Mm-hmm. I mean, you know, I'm going to get in trouble. Paris, okay, Paris, tweet. Well, no, we want to go from the... Oh, I see. Yeah, so... So go from... Just pick up here. Got the mm-hmm. second time. Time and the place and I got rhythm from the towards the end. Mm-hmm. Then take it out to the to the finish, okay?
Yeah. Time and the place.
Give more than that.
Just got the time and the place and I got rhythm. Now all I need's the girl to go with them. If she'll just up here, we'll take this big town for a while.
Smile!
And if she'll say, my darling, I'm yours, I'll throw away my striped tie and my best press tweed.
Take it home!
All I really need is the girl.
So good. So we're basically out of time. The only thing I'd like to suggest is all I really need stop is the girl. That's what I suggest you do at the mm-hmm. end, and that'll give you even more of a showstopper.
Cool.
Thank you, Michael. It is amazing, Michael, what
happens when you smile. Everyone out here, you could all tell. The minute you smile, everyone goes. Like, we feel it. The joy is contagious. So keep smiling.
Thank you so much.
Of course. Great job.
Michael DeLeo, everybody.